So guys, the next topic we are going to study is vestigial sideband. So we saw that in SSB, right, in single sideband, we really need a voice signal or a signal, something of that sort, so that there should be a transition gap, or you can say the spectral gap of some frequency. Let's say in that example we had 600 Hz in terms of voice signal. But if there is not that gap is not there, then it is like very difficult to use band pass filter to get one sideband, whether it is upper sideband, lower sideband. So this is known as selective filtering. So what do you mean by selective filtering is that you want to select a certain range of frequency and you want to eliminate which is outside that. But lighting, that why can't we use phase discrimination? To use phase discrimination method, you have to build an ideal Hilbert transform, and trust me, to generate 90-degree phase shift, exact 90-degree phase shift, is very, very difficult in practical scenario. And it's impossible to build an ideal Hilbert transform phase shifter. And that is the reason that you are not able to use a practical band pass filter. You are not able to use a proper 90-degree phase shift. That's why, if it is not impossible, then still generating signal, a single sideband, is little difficult, little hard. And that's why we compromise between double sideband and single sideband with vestigial sideband. So there comes our hero, vestigial sideband modulation technique. It's a compromise between double sideband and single sideband. And vestigial sideband use a very smart way of, you know, filtering, where we can say that we lose certain amount, and with the help of symmetry, we gain that traces in some other frequency range. So what I'm trying to say is that we lose certain information in certain frequency range, but by the virtue of symmetry, we are able to gain that much in some other frequency range. And when we are doing demodulation, right, and low pass filter is taking care of that plus and minus, and overall no information is lost. So put the heading, guys, vestigial sideband, vestigial sideband modulation. Vestigial sideband modulation. So you can write what we just discussed, because this is very important. VSV is a compromise between DSBSC and SSB. That is the first point. Right? This modulation scheme, this type of modulation, is generated using selective filtering system similar to SSB. Remember, we use a band pass filter similar to single sideband. So the same filter we use here as well. Okay. Next point. So guys, vestigial sideband modulation technique is used for application wise, we use for video signals. Right? So that is the point I'm going to write. The next point, please write. VSB is used in video signal of television means TV. And what is that frequency range? It is 0 to 4.5 megahertz. That is the frequency range. I told you in the very first session. Next point, to generate a VSB signal, the DSB signal, DSB suppressed carrier signal, is passed through a band pass filter. Obviously, a practical band pass filter is passed through a band pass filter. Okay, so let me have the block diagram at the transmitter side as well as the receiver side. Okay, VSB modulator. So you have a signal empty. Okay, and you are multiplying with the carrier, it's a multiplier. Carrier generated through local oscillator. And guys, intentionally I am taking some 2 cos omega ct, so don't panic. Then the output is what? Output is DSP signal. Okay, I am representing this as GT DSP, and this goes into a bandpass filter. Okay, this is important, guys. It goes into a bandpass filter, and the bandpass filter is this. It is VSB omega bandpass filter. That is the frequency response, and finally you get GVSP. Okay. And finally you get GT, but this is not DSP this time, this is VSP. So guys, I am using a very smart notation this time, GT underscore DSP or subscript, and GT subscript VSP. Okay. So this is at the transmitter side, okay, TX, I will write TX. Now, the same GT subscript VSB has been received at the receiver side. So this is your guys VSB demodulator. So modulation, demodulation, we are doing generation and demodulation. And again, you will multiply with the same carrier like what we do as synchronous detector, local oscillator, and this is 2 cos omega ct. Okay, and then the output, whatever you get, let's say call it as some x of t, it is getting into a low pass filter. And the cutoff frequency is, B. Since we are dealing with in terms of omega, so let's write cutoff frequency as 2 pi b. I know it's not frequency, it's radian, but write 2 pi b. Ignore the word frequency for now. And finally, we'll get again Mansus signal. Okay, see, 2 cos omega ct I have taken intentionally, don't worry. If you want to just take cos omega ct, it will do. So, just I have taken from my side, it's nothing to do with, I have replaced AC with 2, okay, so don't worry. Just hold up, you'll get the idea, don't worry. But you understand, it is a simple block where you are actually multiplying a message with a carrier using a bandpass filter, a practical one. To demodulate, you are using the signal, VSV signal, multiplying with the carrier and using a low pass filter. So as you have heard or seen so many times, that you have a bandpass filter in the transmitter side and you have a low pass filter in the receiver side, and that is one of the questions as well. Okay, so clear on this at least? Okay. Yes, this is nice. So this is 2 pi b. This is minus 2 pi b. This is 0. This is omega. This is m of omega. Okay. Now, since you are multiplying with the carrier, it will shift in the left and the right. So you get something like this. Okay. And similarly, you'll get something like this here as well. Okay. So this will go to omega C. Omega C. And this is omega C plus 2 pi B. Okay. This is omega C minus 2 pi B. This is minus omega C plus 2 pi B. Minus omega C minus 2 pi B. So guys, this is your DSP suppressed signal. This is message. Any problem till now? Easy? Now, the going further, what we are going to do, that part is little tricky, guys. So, you know that, so this part, I'm shading like this. I hope you can see, like this part. Okay? Mirror image. Don't miss the mirror image of funda, okay? And this is something this parallel. Okay. Something like this. Okay. Now. Have to go down on the floor. This is the most difficult spectrum which I generally draw. Generally, people will skip this part. I don't do that. Now, let me have the support line going nicely till the last end. Okay. Now, you have a filter in place, so you have to also go like this, okay? And you have to also get the other support lines, okay? So do it nicely, very good, we are there, okay? Now the filter time, guys. So filter, to draw filter is not that difficult. It's almost correct. I know it's not that easy to draw, but give your best shot and you will get it. Yes. like I just got it. Okay? Now this has come somewhere here. Okay? Same thing we have to do it here, guys. Since we are talking about upper sideband, okay, so that's why this is pointing at upper sideband, USB. So your other filter would be like this. So this center it will go, okay, and it has to meet like this. Make sense? Now the output is too crazy. If you look at this, now what is going to happen? Okay. Now what is going to happen? The output you will get is something like this. So this is omega C. This is omega C minus omega C minus omega C. Okay. So the output is something like this. So it's a little tricky. So I'm putting my all efforts here. Okay, so it will be something like this. And then go on. Guys, so this was our band pass filter, this is DSB signal, this is band pass filter, but do you notice that this extra part is coming a little differently from here and there as well. See, if I redraw it again, sorry. So it is something like this, going from center. Yes. And similarly, you have something like this. Yes. Okay, so just to quickly revisit, this was our message signal, right? This is double sideband, shifted in the right, shifted in the left. Okay, and then we're using a practical bandpass filter. So it's a practical bandpass filter. Now if you look at these dotted lines, you might get confused, but don't worry, I will help you out. This dotted line is at the omega C. This is at this triangle ka corner, and you have this line, and this is at the end. The other is at the center of this, and other is here. Similarly, the mirror image is on the left hand side. Now look at this graph. Now what is happening, that you are supposed to get everything. See, here, this black part has come till here. This black part had come, right? If you look at this, so this is your black part. This, 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 this. But you also see that you have also taken something from the blue part. Can you see it, guys? Similarly, you have done here. This extra. So this is known as vestiges. Vestiges means traces. Some extra part. Okay? Now, how does it work? It tries to symmetrically compensate what it has lost. Okay. So if you look at this, this is omega C plus this. But if you look at this, this extra part, we call it as, you know, omega V. Similarly, we call it as minus omega V. This is Vestiges frequency. Okay. Now, if you look at this closely, and how it will help in demodulation, then you will understand that you are supposed to get this complete triangle, right? This thing. At least you are supposed to get this part, right? If you focus, you wanted to get this, but you have lost this part. So guys, those who are not able to see, please see that you have lost this part. Lost. Similarly, here also, you have lost this part. And one small correction, guys. This band pass filter is also symmetric. So it is going something like this. Yes. Something like this. Similarly, here as well. So, one typo happened. Yeah. That is the reason you are getting this much gone. Because this is the reason to get it lost. A small correction. You don't need to do it. Even don't draw this diagram, okay? Whenever you want to revise, go back in the video and see it. Because it's very difficult to draw. Trust me. Now, this is lost. This is lost. Okay? And you have got this extra. Right? This is lost. This is extra you have got. This is lost. This is extra you have got. And they are symmetric. If you look closely, then whatever you are getting extra, exactly they have lost it. So, I can say that whatever you got extra and actually what you lost is equal. So, no information lost. Now, what they are going to do? This is like getting the VSB signal. So, this is your vestigial sideband. Okay. Now, in demodulation, what will happen? Again, the same funda. You will shift this in the right, you will shift this in the left. So, what will happen? I will draw here. When you shift this, this is what? Minus omega C. This will come at 0. And this is plus omega C. When you shift in the left, it will come at 0. Rest, everything we have to ignore. Watch it. What is going on? 2 omega C. Correct now? So, if you shift this in the omega C, it will go to 2 omega C. So, ignore this. It will go to 0. Have it. If you shift in the left, it will go to 0. Have it. It will go to minus 2 omega C. Ignore it. Correct? So, what I am going to do, I am going to take that one. It is something like this. So, that one, which is like this. Very difficult to draw, but I'm trying my best. Okay? And this is your extra part. And this one, which will be okay? Now look at that. This extra blue will fill in here. So I'm filling here. The extra blue coming from this side, okay? This extra blue coming from here will fill in here. It will be fill in like this. And the extra black which is coming from this one. So extra blue is coming from this side is getting there. Extra black which is coming from the other one. Or it, actually it is also blue. But it will be fill in here. Right? If you look at this, did you get what you wanted? Look at that. It's very difficult to do it on the board. It's an animation kind of stuff. But did you see? Did you get your message signal? Yes or no, guys? So how this extra vestige is taking care of each other symmetrically? Let me tell you again that it was earlier like this. Okay? This was like this. Okay? So anyway, this is already having this area, right? And then you are bringing this, so suppose you have something number 2 and then you put another number, it's like 1, you will add it, right? 2 plus 1, 3. So this extra blue is coming and filling in there, right? It's getting filled here like this because it is symmetric, and that extra blue is from the other side is also coming and filling in here. And finally get it, this signal. I hope it answers your question. The area which is lost and which came as extra are symmetric, but do they carry the same information for exact compensation? Yes, that is the reason it is able to compensate. They have exactly the same information. What you are losing. So, don't think like that. When I say information means what? The information is inside this complete frequency range. What you are missing here What you are missing here, you get it from there. So they have created a way. It's a, if you look at the practical side, you will get to know that, okay, it's the same information there. Okay. And why it is same information? Because it's a double sideband. So guys, I'm going to clean up, right? I'm going to clean. So this is your M omega. You have got your message signal, okay? The VSP modulated signal assumes that that the VSB filter, vestigial sideband filter, what I'm trying to say is transition band of VSV filter. So VSV modulated signal assumes that the VSV filter is symmetric. So we are talking about the band pass filter, guys, here. So the VSV filter is symmetric in a way that adding the desired adding the part that remains in the filtered signal from the undesired side, that blue color, guys, from the undesired side band to the missing part of the desired side. Remember the black missing part, to the missing part of the desired side, band during the demodulation process, produces the original message signal. Now I will never forget this, because it exactly tells that what we did at the demodulation time. Okay. Come on, guys. This is the question time. You are seeing at the screen. Question number 2. In a double sideband full carrier AM transmission system, if the modulation index is doubled, then the ratio of total sideband power to the carrier power increases by a factor of, that is the question. Okay, you can look at the question on the screen. So it says that in a double sideband full carrier AM transmission system, so we are talking about AM signal, right? Now, if the modulation index is double, then the ratio of total sideband power to the carrier power. So, total power is PT equal to PC 1 plus mu square by 2. Correct? Now, sideband power is PC mu square by 2. Carrier power is anyway PC. Now, ratio of these two. So, P sideband by PC, ratio of total sideband to the carrier power increases by a factor. So, PC mu square by 2 upon PC. So, it is actually mu square by 2. And if it is getting double, right? So, this ratio will become what? Now, the new mu, right, is equal to twice mu. So, it will be what? Twice mu ka whole square by 2. So, it is 4 times mu square by 2. So, it is increases by a factor of 4. You have to do the fill in the blanks. Answer is 4. Okay? Next question, guys. Question number 5. Attempt this question. Question number 5. It's a GATE 2009 question. What is the answer? Come on. Okay. So guys, this question says, for a massive signal MT cos 2 pi FMT and FC. So massive signal is given as cos 2 pi FMT. Okay. And carrier signal is AC cos 2 pi FCT. Now, which one of the following is the conventional AM signal, right? That is the, sorry, which one of the following represents a single sideband signal? So, you know that option A is DSB. Option A is DSB. Option B, so I'm let me tell you. Option B is just carrier. Option C is upper sideband. And option D is AM. Look at that, how I have converted it. So what is your answer? You need for a single sideband? Answer is option C. Very good, guys. But also look at the other options now. Clear? Next question. Question number 6. Question number 6. Suppose that the modulating signal MT equal to 2 cos 2 pi FMT. 2 cos 2 pi FMT. Okay. And the carrier signal is AC cos 2 pi FCT. So, guys, this information you can ignore, which I wrote in this question. This is from question number 6. Which of the following is a conventional AM? Option A. Let me go through one by one in all the options. AC MT cos 2 pi FCT. What is this, guys? Come on, ping me. What is this guy? This is double sideband suppressed carrier. This option A, double sideband suppressed carrier. Option A cannot be the answer. Correct, guys? Option B is a conventional AM, but there, what is the problem? Let me write first. It is AC 1 plus MT cos 2 pi FCT. Now, you know that MT is 2. So, here if you write 2 cos 2 pi FMT, what is mu here? Mu equal to 2. This cannot be the answer. Yes or no, guys? So option A gone, option B gone. See, I'm going through one by one. I'm going through all the options one by one. Option C. XT equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus AC by 4 mt cos 2 pi fct. So you can take ac cos 2 pi fct common in the way we used to do. 1 by 4 mt is 2 cos 2 pi fmt cos 2 pi fct. So mu is equal to half 0.5. It is less than 1. This is the answer. Don't be happy, huh? We got the answer option C. We got the answer. Very good. Look at what is in the option D. You should study like this. Option D says AC cos 2 pi FCT plus cos 2 pi FMT AC sin 2 pi. So guys, you can know that, right? The last option is what, guys? Single sideband. Then you are my student. Look at that. The first option, DSP. Second option, AM, but mu equal to 2. Third option, mu equal to less than, mu equal to half, less than 1. But AM. Fourth option, single sideband. Are we good on this question? Move to the next question. That's how you should attempt the question. Question number 7, guys. It's a straightforward question. Question number 7. You can quickly answer. Answer is SSB. Option C. Very good. You know that out of these, which one of the following analog modulation scheme requires the minimum transmitted power and minimum channel bandwidth? Minimum transmitted power is required by SSB. Minimum channel bandwidth is W. So this is the only modulation technique. VSB requires more than SSB, less than DSB. So keep in mind, answer is option C. No need to discuss. Gone. This is done. Question number 10. So guys, in this, if you read the question, it is saying a 1 MHz sinusoidal carrier is amplitude modulated by symmetrical square wave, right? So that message signal is a symmetrical square wave of period 100 microseconds. So you have to actually convert this into harmonics of sinusoids. And how will you convert that? By using Fourier series. Which of the following frequency will not be present in the modulated signal? Okay. So given that the baseband signal means having low frequency, the baseband signal means you can think it as massive signal, is a symmetrical square wave of period 100 microseconds. Correct? This is what given in the question. Now guys, if you apply Fourier series representation for this, right? So how will you write? It's a symmetrical square wave. It will be something like this. Okay? Must have studied in your signal system. Now if it's symmetrical square wave, it is having even symmetry. So it will have only even terms. Means it will not have odd terms of omega naught. It will have 2 omega naught, 0, 2 omega naught, 4 omega naught, 6 omega naught, like that. So finally, even symmetry, odd symmetry. So it will have even symmetry. So it will have omega 3 omega naught terms. Okay. Not like even power. Sorry, my bad. So it will not have even terms. It will have odd terms. Okay. So the representation will look like something like this. 4 by pi cos omega ct minus 1 by 3 cos 3 omega ct plus 1 by 5 cos 5 omega ct plus so on. Okay. So this is your, let's say, massive signal. So if it is modulating the carrier, what will happen? Carrier, actually don't write omega CT, sorry. You write omega M, 3 omega M. Okay, please change it, a little typo there, so that you don't get confused. Now you know that 3 time period is 100 microsecond. So if this 100 microsecond, so how much is the frequency? It will be 1 by 100 microsecond, 10 key power minus 6, 10 key power 6 by 100. So it will be 10 key power 4 means 1000. It will be 10 kilohertz. Correct, guys? Now, this is like FM. What is FC they have given? 1 megahertz. So it will be 1000 kilohertz. And you know that when you shift this with this thing, it will give you, so this will give you what? FC plus FM and FC minus FM. This will give you, follow the arrow, 3FM and FC minus 3FM. Okay? And similarly, it will give you FC plus 5FM and FC minus 5FM. So what are the frequency we'll get? Here you will get what? FC plus FM, 1000, 10, 9, 90. Here you will get 1000, 30, 9, 70. Here you will get 1000, 50. Because 1000 plus 50, 1050. And here you will get 950. Looking at the option, you will get 990, yes. You will get 1010, yes. You will get 1030, yes. But you will not get 1020. Answer is option C. It's a very good question. Put a star or something. Okay, so question number 13 says an unmodulated carrier in an AM transmitter is 5 kilowatt. So PC is 5 kilowatt, means 5000 watts. This carrier is modulated by a sinusoidal modulating signal. Okay, the maximum percentage of modulation is 50%. So mu is equal to 0.5. Or you can also call it as half. This is a very recent question, GATE 2017. So what is total transmitted power? It is PC 1 plus mu square by 2. So 5000, 1 plus half. So this is something 5000 into 9 by 8. Don't simplify for now. Keep it like this. So this is the total transmitted power, right? Now the question, in the question they are saying, if it is reduced to 40%, then the modulation, maximum unmodulated carrier power. How much carrier power it can take, given the fact that you are not overloading the transmitter? It means that PT cannot change. So PT is fixed. They are asking what is the new PC dash with the new, you know, new modulation index, mu dash square by 2. So PT is, you know, what is PT? 5000 9 by 8 PC dash, and it is saying 40% means 0.4, so 0.16 by 2. So PC dash is equal to 5000 into 9 divided by 8. And this is 0.08, so it will be 8 into 1.08. If you solve this, you will get 5208 watts. In kilowatt, it is 5.208 kilowatt. I will not do the calculation. Okay, so this is also done, guys. A very good question, very easy question. For 1 mark, it came in 2017. Now, moving to the next question, question number 14. Okay, now this question says that, what is the question? Question says that in the system shown in figure, MT is a low pass signal with bandwidth W hertz. The frequency response of the band pass filter, H of L is shown in figure B. If it is desired that the output signal Z t equal to only 10 XT. So guys, given is question number 14. Given X t is equal to MT cos 24 pi t. So intentionally I am writing like this. So you clearly see that this is a multiplication of two signals. So an MT is band limited to, so this is M omega, or we can call it as M of F, is band limited to W, right? The moment you multiply with 1200, how the spectrum of X of F will look like? Come on guys, tell me. So it will look like something like this, correct? So it will go in the right, it will go in the left, it will be, how much is that? 1200, this is 1200 plus W, 1200 minus W, minus 1200 plus W, minus 1200 minus W. Yes or no? Now, Y of t is equal to 10 times x t plus x square t, correct? And it is going into the bandpass filters. You know that what is Y of f? So first of all, you need to understand how x square t will look like, okay? So let me do that. 10 XT is too easy, so X square T is what? Square of that signal, it is M square T into cos square 2 pi 1200 T. And you know that what we do in this case. We write M square T 1 plus cos 2 pi into 2400 T by 2. Correct guys? Now, you are getting m square t by 2 plus this term. So, m square t by 2, m square t by 2 cos 2 pi into 2400 t. So, if I say, what is the spectrum of this, if I take the Fourier transform. So, let's say x spectrum of this is x square f. It will look like something like this. So you have a m square t, I taught you in the first session, mt if it is m of f, m square t will be m square f. So it is multiplication of m of into mf. It is actually frequency will get doubled. So you get 2w minus 2w 0. But you will also have something on the side of 2400. So you will have here something 2400 plus 2w. 2400 minus 2W, and this looks so big, so let me make it small, a little small, something like this. So minus 2W plus 2W, okay guys, and shift in the left, it will be something like similar. So minus 2400 minus 2400 plus 2W. And this is minus 2400 minus W. Clear guys? Guys, this is the spectrum of X square F. Okay? Or, if you are good enough, then you will understand that this question is done here only. Now, you don't want X square T. You just want X of T at the output. That is written in the question that if the output signal only 10 XT is desired, means you have to take this out. You have to eliminate this spectrum. And your bandpass filter, which they have given in the next slide, it is running from 700 to 1700, which means 1000 here. And similarly here, minus 700 minus 1700, right? Correct? Yes. Now your job is to make sure that this thing is outside here, this thing is coming somewhere here, and this thing is outside below there, behind this. So you can put some condition that this triangle come and fit in somewhere here, like that. So you can write 2W should be less than 700, okay? This is the max. If it is less than that, then anyway it will be taken care. And this part, 24 minus 2W, it should be more than 1700. So 2400 minus 2W should be more than 1700. These are the two conditions that you are supposed to apply. Okay? Let me check what is the answer then. Generally, whenever you want to find mean or max, you have to put equality. It's an ideal situation. So it will only give you omega less than equal to 350, which I think Chetkar must have done. Even if you solve this, you will get the same result. So 2 omega should be less than 700. So omega is coming as 350. Chetkar, this is the way you got it, man?